हरिवर हरिवर हरे ओम अज्ञानतिरामरस्य चक्षुर्विगंगेन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिका वै तदालै कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः। नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरक्तिसे नमः। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपीश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुती देवी प्रणमामि हरे प्रिय। ओं वृंदावई तुलसी देवी प्रिया वै केशवस्य च कृष्णभक्ति प्रदे देवी सत्यवत्ये नमो। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि श्री गौरभक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई ऑफर माय हम्बल respectful obeisances unto lotus feet of my Gurupad Padma Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnupad Ashtutara Satasya Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Srila Bhavan Goswami Maharaj and Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnupad Ashtutara Satasya Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj. Simultaneously offer my humble respectful dandavat pranam lotus feet of Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnupad अष्टोत्तर सदस्य श्रीमद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज श्रील गौरवंद गोस्वामी महाराज श्रील भक्ति रक्ष श्रीधर गोस्वामी महाराज श्रील भक्ति प्रमोद पुरी गोस्वामी महाराज श्रील भक्ति विज्ञान भारती गोस्वामी महाराज एंड ऑल सीनियर डिवोटीज एंड ऑल वैष्णव एंड वैष्णवीज एंड प्रेजेंटेड ऑल ऑफ माई रेस्पेक्टफुल गेस्ट। सो टुडे इज वेरी सुपर एक्सलेंट ऑस्पिशियस डे स्पेशली इन आवर गौड़ीय संप्रदाय in the land of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu's eternal associates Nitya Parikar, his Nitya Parikar Raya Ramananda, his disappearance day. So I want to speak few words about Raya Ramananda and how he was in great devotee of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Raya Ramananda, he was the church Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's and among of the three and half and internal associates in Saritin Parikars, and among of them Raya Ramananda Sarup Damodar, Raya Ramananda Sikhimaiti and Madhavi Devi. So Raya Ramananda, he was very prominent and nearest and dearest of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And first we also explain that Raya Ramananda, he was born in Jagannath Puri. And he was the governor of king of Pratapudra in Orissa and very close to him. But especially he also the governor of South India, Dakshin Bharat. And Raya Ramananda, actually he is the son of Bhavananda. And Bhavananda Bhavananda's has fifth sons. So Raya Ramananda is very prominent. Bhavananda's wife name was Kunti Devi. In the womb of Kunti Devi, Raya Ramananda was born. In Kavikars, in Gaur Ganadish Dupika, Kavikarnapur also glorified about Raya Ramananda. Raya Ramananda And he was in Radha Krishna Leela, that is called the Visakha Devi. And especially when Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu absorbed in his transcendental Virha separation mode in Gambhira, that time only Rayananda and Sarvadamodar pacified to him. Krishnadas Kaviraj in Chaitanya Chaitamrita clearly explained. And Birahir Kali Duhe Rakhay Paran Rayer Natogar Sarupir Gan Duhe Birahir Kali Rakhay Paran. That means when Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu completely submerged in transcendental madness of Srimati Radhika, and that time Sarup Damodar Rai Ramananda and pacified to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and as like in Vrindavan, when Srimati Radhika, she felt pang of separation from Srimati Krishna. That time Lalita and Visakha pacified to Srimati Radhika. In the same way, when Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was staying in Gambhira and felt the pang of separation from Krishna, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was thinking, I am Radha, now my beloved Krishna left me. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu day and night was crying, and especially last 12 years, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was thinking, I am Radha, now my beloved Krishna left me in Vrindavan to Mathura. So that time, Sarup Damodar and Rai Ramananda, they also recited many slokas, Srimad Bhagavatam, especially Rai Ramananda. He recited his own Grantha Natakam, that is Jagannath Ballabh Natakam. And that is very separation mode. So when Rai Ramananda, he recited his own Granthas, slokas, and Jagannath Ballabh Natakam, that time Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's separation increased more and more. But Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's servant Govinda, he did not understand why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was crying, and Rai Ramananda and Sarva Damodar also increased his crying. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's heart only realized Sarva Damodar and Rai Ramananda, for this regard Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was crying and separation from Krishna. And that time Rai Ramananda, he recited some verses of Srimad Bhagavatam, Gopi Gita, Venu Gita, Jugal Gita, Bhramar Gita. Then Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's separation mood was going and more increasing and increasing. So in this way, actual Rai Ramananda, he was very nearest and dearest of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Even Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself also glorified to Rai Ramananda. Rai Ramananda, actually he is the liberated person, Mukta Mahaprabhu. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself told to the devotee Rai Ramananda, he is not an ordinary person. Once Pradyumna Mishra, one Brahman boy, Pradyumna Mishra, he came to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, listen Harikatha from the lotus leaves of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, very humble, he told, Ami jato nahi jani, tato jane Rai Ramananda. What will you speak about Harikatha? But Rai Ramananda, he knows better than me. So you have to go listen Harikatha from Rai Ramananda. So according to instruction of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then Pradyumna Mishra Brahmachari, he came in the house of Rai Ramananda, and then he asked the servant of Rai Ramananda, and the servant of Rai Ramananda, he told, oh, Rai Ramananda, he is now in one confidential place in the garden, and he is giving some teaching and young girls about the drama of Jagannath Ballabh Natakam. And that time, when heard this thing, then Pradyumna Mishra's Brahmachari's mind little bit disturbed. Then he returned back and he asked Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rai Ramana Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he asked to Padmana Mishra, did you listen Hari Katha from Rai Ramananda? Then Padmana Mishra, he did not say anything, little bit shy. Sarvantar Jami Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, and he Rai Ramananda and Padmana Mishra, he returned back to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sarvantarjami, that means Chaitanya Mahaprabhu knows the heart of the all the living entities. Sarvantarji Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, okay, so you go next morning to the house of Lord Rai Ramananda and tell to him that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sent me to listen Harikatha from your lotus leaves. So next morning, Pradyumna Mishra Brahmachari, he came in the house of Rai Ramananda. Then Rai Ramananda very humble and gave him asan to the Brahmachari. And when Brahmachari told Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, sent him to listen Harikatha from his lotus leaves. Then Rai Ramananda was pleased. Then Rai Ramananda talked about Gopi Gita, Bhramar Gita, all kinds of separation mode very nicely and within ecstatic mode. And then Padmana Brahmachari, he realized what kinds of devotee of Rai Ramananda. Then he satisfied his Harikatha. Then again he returned back to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then Padmana Mishra completely also sent to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, told Prabhu, now I realize he is Rai Ramananda. Then Mahaprabhu also again and glorified about Rai Ramananda. Listen, Rai Ramananda, he is completely liberated person, Mukta Purush. And in solitary place, he also touched the young girls, but his mind not disturbed, not anything. Mahaprabhu told Anner Kakatha, what you will say to about others, even I am sannyasi, and even I see the Prakriti, and see, maybe my mind will be disturbed. But Rai Ramananda, his mind never disturbed his. So Iti Jani Rai Ramananda, Hai Mukta Purush. So for this regard, Rai Ramananda, he is called a liberated person, Mukta Mahapurush. So many kathas also in this way. And though Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very strictly and chastised to Chota Haridas, just he brought some rice from the house of Madhavi Devi, and she was very old and 80 years old lady, and she was very nearest dear Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he heard Chota Haridas, he brought the rice from her house. Then Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu strictly chastised and rejected him. That is called Chota Haridas Danda Leela, also explained. And in this Leela, Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada did not give any explanation why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu chastised to Chota Haridas and what is his fault. No one can explain. Once I also asked my Gurudev Bhavan Goswami Maharaj in Navadvip Dham. That time Gurudev told, and even Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada did not give any commentary why, so you should not ask why. This is his Leela. Sannyasi Brahmachari's Siksha, just he is giving some teaching to us. So no need to give any commentary. Why Chota Haridas, why Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu rejected to Chota Haridas? क्यों चैतन्य महाप्रभु छोटा हरिदास के वर्जन के त्याग दिया, इसके कारण क्या है, What is the reason? Well, you cannot say even Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada, and Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur in his Amrit Prabhavashra did not mention anything. And just he explained, Lok Siksha Tare Prabhu Karana E Lila. For the teaching for the others, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and giving this Lila. So we should not give any commentary. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu chastised to Chota Haridas? And sometimes devotee asks my Gurudev, or if Chota Haridas would not go to Madhavi Devi's, bring rice, maybe he would committed offense, lotus feet of, what is his name? And, because that day Chaitanya Mahaprabhu have to would take prasad. And what is his name? Because he was also Vaishnava. And so if Chota Hriday would not and follow the instruction of his name, I forget. If he would not go to bring that rice from Madhavi Devi, then he would also committed offense to the spirit of Vaishnava. So now coming in this way, Lord Chaitanya, so my Gurudev, he told, don't you give any commentary. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu have chastised to Chota Haridas? Just you try to understand the Loka Siksha. And Loka Siksha, the teaching to the others, because after Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's and maybe people will become Sahaja Sukhi Bhagi for this regard. This is the enough. And Bhavan, what is his name? Or Jiske Ghar Mein Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Prasad Ped. Just I forget the name. And because Lord Chaitanya will have to take Prasad in his house. Midtime, then there is not rice in his house. And not. Bhagwan Das, someone wrote, this is true, in the house of Bhagwan Das. Bhagwan Das also, he was great Vaishnava, and also very near distant, dear Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Bhagwan Das, he also gave order to Chota Haridas, dear Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would take prasad in my house, but in my house not, and the fine rice. So you may bring the fine rice from Madhavi Devi. And Madhavi Devi, she was very old also, 80 years old. Her hair completely white. And she was also very nearest and dearest to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So for this regard, try to understand what is the reason. No one can explain this way. Only just written in here, Lok Siksha Tare Prabhu Karena ei lila. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu performed this lila and for the teaching for the others. No need to give any commentary. If you give one commentary, my Gurudev Bhavan Goswami Maharaj, he told, maybe you commit offenses, lotus feet of Vaishnavas. And so don't give any commentary because Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada did not give any commentary. Even Bhaktivinoda Thakur also did not give any commentary about this subject. So why you will just give the imaginary commentary? So try to understand this way. So why I am saying, because Rai Raman, the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself glorified about Rai Ramananda, he also Mukta Mahapurush. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very humble. He told, even I see the wooden form of the ladies, maybe my mind will be also disturbed. And so, but Rai Ramananda, he direct and touch the private part of the ladies, young girls, and teaching to them about the Jagannath Vallabh Natakam, but his mind never disturbed. So in this way, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he told Rai Ramananda, he is Mukta Mahapurush. So but Rairabandho, before met with Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and then Rairabandho, he wrote many Radha Krishna's Lila Katha in his Grantha also, and especially Srimati Radhika's, and eight types of moods, and he wrote on his Grantha, and that is called Abhisarika, Vasak Sajja, etc. This way, and especially his famous song, that is Kalayati Nayanam Disi Disi Balitam Pankajamibo Maruta Chalitam. In this verse, last he also wrote this verse, and Janayati Rudra Ganadhipa Muditam Ramananda Raya Kovi Gaditam. And in this verse, Kalayati Nayanam Disi Disi Balitam, in this and song, Srimati Radhika's Abhisarika Nayika's mode also explained very nicely. And he also explained in this way, Srimati Radhika, when Srimati Radhika, she proceed to meet with her beloved Krishna, and how Srimati Radhika's bodily expression here very nicely explained in this way. That is called Abhisarika Nayika Srimati Radhika. And last line he also wrote, Janayati Rudra Gajadhipa Muditam Ramananda Raya Kovi Gaditam. And Raya Ramananda, here is the first Raya Ramananda, very humbly saying in this way, I composed this song by the pleasure of King Pratap Rudra. And he Rudra, Janayati Rudra Gajadhipa Muditam, because King Pratap Rudra, his title also in Gajapati. So here is Janayati Rudra. Here Rudra means Pratap Rudra, and Muditam Ramananda Raya Kavi Gaditam. And Raya Ramananda, he was very high class, exalted, rasik, and Acharya also. And he was also very nearest and dearest of King Pratap Rudra, Gajapati, King Pratap Rudra. And he is also Sabhakavi of King Pratap Rudra. And because ancient time, most of the king, they also keep the high class philosophers and also poets in his assembly house, Sabha. So in the same tradition, King Pratap Rudra, he also kept King Pratap Raya Ramananda in his council, and that is called the Sabhakavi. Not he was only Sabhakavi, also before I also told, he was the governor of South India in the kingdom of King Pratap Rudra. King Pratap Rudra, he was also nearest and dearest of Lord Jagannath, very nearest and dearest of Lord Jagannath. And he was also rasik. For this regard, he has so much love and affection with Raya Ramananda. So in this way, we see how Raya Ramananda, he was very high class, exalted devotee of Lord. When Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came in Jagannath Puri, and he also delivered Sarvabhattacharya, then he realized that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is the supreme personality of Godhead, Sang Bhagavan. And then Sarvabhattacharya completely, socially surrendered lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Sarvabhattacharya also himself glorified about Raya Ramananda. When Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu expressed his heart to all the associates of King Pratap Rudra, then the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he told, I have to go to South India to find out my brother Vishwaroop. I heard my young my elder brother Vishwaroop And he took sannyas. So I have to go to South India and find out where is my brother Viswarup. So that time, Sarvam Bhattacharya, very humble, he told Prabhu, if you would go to South India, you must meet with Rai Ramananda in Kapur, Mahindra. In that place, actually, Kapur in Mahindra, on the bank of in river ki kya naam hai, Godavari. You have to meet with him. Because Sarvam Bhattacharya, he told, before I was completely heard, impartialist, and the philosophers of Shankar philosophers, just I also recited the Shankar four mantras, Aung Brahmasmi, Pragyanang Brahma, Sarvam Kalidang Brahma, Tattamasi. But by your causeless mercy, now we realize what is the perfect and real meaning of Brahma. So, and now realize, ye Prabhu, who are you? So, for this regard, and you are Rai Ramananda, and is your best associate Parikar. Why? Because when Rai Ramananda, he was with us in Jagannath Puri, in our any meeting, when Rai Ramananda used to come, and he just also talked about Gopi's Katha. Then all we also laughed and joked about him. Yeah, how possible Brahma perform Raj dance, this, and because Brahma is called Atmaram, Aptakam. And so we did not accept his lecture about Brahma's Raj dance and this thing. That time we laughed and joked. But now, your causeless mercy, we realize why Rai Ramananda, and he also talked about Krishna, who is the Supreme Personality of God, is saying Bhagavan, and how did he perform Raj dance with the gopis? Because now we realize Krishna, he is called Rasik Brahma. Before we were thinking, Lord Brahma is called only Shushka Brahma. Shushka means dry Brahma. Now by your causeless, we realize Krishna is called Rasik Brahma. For this regard, Rai Ramananda, most of the time in our Mayavadi assembly house, he talked about gopis and Krishna's very sweet, amorous pastimes. That time we also joked and laughed with him. But now we realize Rai Ramananda, how is high class exalted Vaishnav. Rai Ramananda, Sarvam Bhattacharya, he told also, and before we just also making the sound as like jackal, and how, and Brahma. Now by your causeless mercy, we realize how Krishna, he is called Rasik Brahma, and also Rai Ramananda, he talked about Rasik Brahma, Krishna's so sweet, amorous pastimes. So Rai Ramananda told, ye Prabhu, you are going to South India, you must to meet with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you must with Rai Ramananda, Jogena Jogya Jyoti. When qualified person meet with qualified person, that means you are also Rasik, Brahma, and Rai Ramananda, he also Rasik, you must meet with him. So in this way, Sarvam Bhattacharya, he also gave instruction to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sarvam Bhattacharya, he quoted one verse. Tomar sangi yogyo teho ekjon prithivite rasik bhakta nahi tar samo. Sarvam Bhattacharya, he glorified about Rai Ramananda. Tomar sangi yogyo teho ekjon, only one qualified person in this material world, no one can equal with him. And so you must meet with Rai Ramananda, and he is also Rasik Bhakta. So for this, here Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, quoted this verse, Chaitanya Chaitamritam, Madhya Lila, 7th chapter, 64, and verse, Tomar Sangi Yogyo Teho Ek Jan, Prithivite Rasik Bhakta Nahi Tar Samam. And also told, Ye Prabhu, Raymond also told, don't you also neglect him. Ye is Sudra. Don't you neglect him. But Rai Ramananda, he is also Rasik and also Pandit. He is great philosopher and also Rasik Acharya. So, according to the instruction of Sarvam Bhattacharya, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he proceed to South India, then he came in Kovur, Vidyanagar, and then that and same time Rai Ramananda, he also came to take birth in the river of Godavari with many Brahmanas. And all the Brahmanas, they also chanted Vedic mantra. But Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after taking his birth, he was sitting little bit far from the birthplace and Snan Ghat. But Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu manifested his very nice, beautiful effulgence. Because Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's body, that is called Tapta Kanchana Gauranga. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's bodily conception, that is called the molten gold. And also Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his sannas base, very nice, beautiful, saffron color. And for this regard, four directions completely illuminated with Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Arun Vasan and his also bodily conception. And then when Rai Ramananda, he came in that place to take birth in the river of Godavari, and the Brahmanas also chanting the Vedas mantra. But when Rai Ramananda, he saw to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rai Ramananda can't control his ecstatic mood. And Rai Ramananda, he came to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and also embraced to him in this way. Then all the Vedic Brahmanas, they became very surprised. Why Sannyasi? And he embraced the Visayi Sudra, Rai Ramananda. Because mundane people, they cannot understand the heart of pure devotee. Rai Ramananda, he is pure devotee. The Vedic Smarta Brahmanas, they could not understand. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also embraced to Rai Ramananda. Then duhe milane, when they meet together, then both heart completely overjoyed in ecstatic mood. Yadi tahadiki vaidyak brahmane vailo ascharya on and seeing these types of activities, the meeting of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Rai Ramananda, what kinds of ecstatic mood manifested. And here also explained, Surya sama kanti oruna vasan Subalita Prakanda Deho Kamala Luchan. Here Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami also glorified how Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu manifested his effulgence. Surya sama kanti oruna vasan and Subarana Prakanda Deho Kamala Luchan. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's effulgence as like the effulgence of sun, and very nice, beautiful, saffron colors. And his body, bodily complexion as like the molten gold. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu lies as like blossom lotus. And in this way, when after taking birth, Rai Ramananda, and again he also touched the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and both also meeting together. In the same time, and one Vedic Brahmana, and he came and he asked Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, "Ye Prabhu, you have to take prasad in my house." And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu then accept his invitation, nimantran, and also Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told to Raya Ramananda, "Okay, you have to come and evening time in his house, both will meet together and discuss these things." And because Raya Ramananda daytime so much busy in his royal duties. So for this regard, Raya Ramananda, he used to come to meet with Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in evening time, very simple way. And that time also Raya Ramananda Chaitanya Mahaprabhu discussed many Tattva Siddhanta, these things. That is called Raya Ramananda Sangbad. This is called the Raya Ramananda Sangbad. This is Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami explained in Chaitanya Charitamritam, Madhya Lila, 18th chapter. Very nice, beautiful. This is Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. How did he discuss about Varnashram Dharma? In this way, discuss this way. Here also explain this way. Pratasnan kari asana basiya ekbhitya sangirai midiya namaskar kaila rai prabhu kaila lingane dui jane krishna katha kai se istane prabhu kai paraslok sadhire ninnay rai kai sadharma acharane vishnu bhakti hai. And very nice, beautiful conversation between Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Raya Ramananda. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asks, what will you speak? Have to give evidence from the Shastra. Jaha koibe dibe Shastra praman. What will we speak? Have to give the evidence from the Shastra. Shastra praman. So here first Lord Chaitanya Prabhu asked about Sadhir Ninoy. What is the goal? That time Prabhu kai parasluk sadhir nirnoy rai kai sadharma acharane vishnu bhakti hai varnashram acharata vata puruse na paro puman vishnu aradhate pantha nanna tattva sakaranam. And then Raya Ramananda, first he started from varnashram dharma. And Prabhu kai rai kai sadharma acharane vishnu bhakti hai. That means one who follows the rules and regulation of the society, then he will be attain his perfection goal. And sadharma acharan, that is called varnashram dharma. So for this regard, Vishnu Parasukta and Vishnu Puran also quoted this verse, varnashram acharatavata purusena parapuman vishnu aradhati pantha nannatottasa karanam. Then everybody have to follow the rules and regulation of varna and ashram, then Lord Vishnu will be pleased. That means brahmachari, grihastha, vanprastha and sannyasi, and brahman, kshatriya, vaishya and shudra, then Vishnu will be pleased. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what did he say? Prabhu kahi eva jya age kaha ar rai kahi krishne karma arpan sarvasaddha sar. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this is external, because Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to listen. Jivas sarupgata dharma. Because varnashram dharma, that is not the sarupgata dharma of jivas. This is external. Sarupanu bandhi dharma, that is called jivas sarupanu sarupa anubandhi. When it is jivas, that is called the jivas dharma, that is called Krishna Tadash. But here Raya Ramananda, he started from varnashram dharma. But so far this regard, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, Prabhu kai yavajya agi kohar, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Connection is unstable. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, this is an external. Because Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to listen, sarupanu अनुबंधी ऑफ जीवज, जीव स्वरूप अनुबंधी जीव एंड दैट मीन्स दिस स्पॉन्टेनियस नेचर ऑफ द जीव दैट इज कृष्ण दासत्व एंड ऑल द लिविंग एंटिटी दैट दे आर कॉल्ड द इटर्नल एसोसिएट ऑफ कृष्ण, जीव स्वरूप है कृष्ण नित्य दास एंड बट रायरमंद ही स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम वर्णाश्रम धर्म एंड फॉर दिस रिगार्ड प्रभु टोल्ड प्रभु कहे यह वाज्य आगे कहार राय कहे कृष्ण कर्मार्पण सर्वसाध्य सार एम जत करुषि जत जोषि जदासी जत जत पशी कुंती तत्कुरुष मद अर्पणम एंड देन रायरमंद टोल्ड यू ऑफर ऑल योर फ्रूट्स ऑफ कर्म टू कृष्ण एंड बिकॉज मद भागवत गीता कृष्ण सेज टू अर्जुन व्हाट यू विल डू एंड ऑल द फ्रूट्स ऑफर टू मी देन यू विल नॉट एंड एफेक्टेड एनी कर्म सो फॉर दिगर जत करुषि जत अश्नासी जत जोषी ददासी जत जत पशी कौंत्य तत्कुरुष मद अर्पणम प्रभु कहे ये वाज्य आगे कहार चैतन्य महाप्रभु ऑल्सो रोल दिस इज ऑल्सो एक्सटर्नल देन राय कहे सर्व सर्वधर्म त्याग यही साध्य सार दिस इज द हाइस्ट टीचिंग ऑफ श्रीमद भागवत गीता रायरमंद टोल्ड give up all kinds of duty and responsibilities of varnashram dharma and absolutely surrender to Krishna. And then Rayamanda, he also quoted this verse from Srimad Bhagavad Gita. And highest teaching of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, this is called 18th chapter, 66 slokas, sloka number 66. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam braja. अहं त्वं सर्वपापेभ्यो मोक्षयामि मास च अबैंडिंग ऑल द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन ऑफ वर्णाश्रम धर्म एंड कंप्लीटली सरेंडर टू मी आई एश्योर टू यू फ्री फ्रॉम ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ सिनफुल एक्टिविटीज एंड यू विल गेट द लिबरेशन सो डोंट यू लेमेंटेड सुख मत करो प्रभु कहे यह वाज्य आगे कहार चैतन्य महाप्रभु टोल्ड ऑल्सो दिस इज एक्सटर्नल राय कहे ज्ञान मिश्रा भक्ति सर्वसाध्य सार देन राय रमानंद ही टोल्ड ज्ञान मिश्रा भक्ति इस भक्ति मिक्स्ड विथ ज्ञान दैट इज कॉल्ड ज्ञान मिश्रा भक्ति ब्रह्मभूत प्रसन्न आत्मा न शोचते न कांगते सम सर्वेषु भूतेषु मद्भक्ति लभते पराम एंड ब्रह्मभूत प्रसन्न आत्मा न सुजते न कंकति सम सर्वेषु भूतेषु मद्भक्ति लभते पराम एंड वन हु एंड गिव अप ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ अटैचमेंट ऑफ दिस मेटेरियल वर्ल्ड एंड हिज हार्ट इज नॉट and contaminated with any material things, no lamentation, and no any material desires, and he is qualified to attain Brahma, but here is sama sarva bhutesu param. If he attained or associate with my pure devotee, then he will attain parabhakti. But Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also told, प्रभु कहे यह वाज्य आगे कहो और राय कहे ज्ञान सुनना भक्ति सर्वसाध्य सार लॉर्ड चैतन्य महाप्रभु टोल्ड दिस इज ऑल्सो एक्सटर्नल राय कहे ज्ञान सुनना भक्ति ज्ञाने प्रयासे मुदपस्व नमन्ते एव जीवन्ते सन्मुखृतां भवदीय वार्तां स्थाने स्थिता श्रुतिगतां तनुवाङ्नभि जो प्रयासो अजीतो जीतो ओपिस्तोस्तलोकम दिस इज कॉल्ड ब्रह्मस्तुति वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एक्चुअल प्रभु कहे यह है आगे कहार लॉर्ड चैतन्य महाप्रभु प्लीज एंड चैतन्य महाप्रभु एग्रीड वेरी आई दिस इज व्हाई बिकॉज नाउ एंड भक्ति इज कमिंग बिकॉज भक्ति इज फर्स्ट सिम्टम दैट इज कॉल्ड कृष्ण कथा रुचि कृष्ण कथा रुचि ना होइले पंड से श्रम विषक से न कथा सुज नोत्पादे यदि रुति श्रम एव हि केवलम एंड इफ यू हैव नो टेस्ट टू लिसन कृष्ण कथा देन ऑल योर एंडिवर्स एंड parisrami were they got useless, because Krishna Katha means Krishna himself enter in your ears and coming into your heart and clean all your anarthas. Conditional soul cannot to clean his heart, and but here he is saying this Srimad Bhagavata gives evidence. Sinnatang sakata Krishna punna sravana kirtanam hiddansu javadrani vidunutisu hidisatam nashto prayesu avadresu nittang bhagavata sevaya. And every day listen Hari Katha, servicing Lotus Feet of Guru and Vaishnava, then your heart automatically cleaned. Because if you listen Krishna Katha, mean Krishna himself enter in your heart and clean all your unwanted things, anarthas. So here Brahmaji also recited this verse, Gyane Prayase Mudapashra Namanteva Jivanti Sanmukritang Bhavadi Avartam Stane Sitang Sutigatang Tonuvang Navi Jo Prayaso Ajito Jito Apisin Stoilokam. That means once you give up all kinds of the knowledge and completely surrender to Krishna and listen to Krishna Katha, here is three types of knowledge gain. One is called Tatpadartha Gyan, Tampadartha Gyan, and Jiva Brahma Ikka Gyan. Give up the knowledge of oneness with Brahma and Jiva Brahma Ikka Gyan. But two kinds of knowledge and you have to acquire. That's called Tatpadartha Gyan, the knowledge about Krishna. Tampadartha Gyan, the knowledge about your soul. That is called Bhagavat Tattva Gyan and Atma Tattva Gyan. Then this is very important. So for this regard, here is one who have to perform bhakti. Because bhakti is first, that is called Sarvanakha Bhakti. And Prahlad Maharaj, he also mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, Sarvanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Pada Sevanam Achanam Archanam Bandhanam Dasya Sakatma Nivedanam Iti Vangsarvita Vishnu Bhakti Sthet Navalakchanam. And Sravanakha Bhakti, Sravan Bhakti, first Bhakti that is called Sravanakha Bhakti. And to hearing Harikatha from the lotus leaves of Guru and Vaishnava. For this regard, Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Pad explained, Adu Guru Mukhad Harikatha Sravanam, in the beginning have to listen Harikatha from Gurudev, then your confidence will come. And then automatically all kinds of anarthas slowly remove from your heart. And so Sravanakha Bhakti. So in this verse, and very clearly explain, you have to listen Harikatha. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, for this regard, he is saying, Prabhu kahe yo hai, agi kaho ar. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu agreed. Rai kahe prema bhakti sarva saddha sar. Then Rai Ramananda continue, he also explained about prema bhakti. The prema bhakti means two kinds of bhakti. One is called vaidhi bhakti, another is called raganuga bhakti, and that sanatana siksha just we also discussing about Vaidhi Bhakti and Raganuga Bhakti. In the same way here, Ramananda very clearly explained. And first, everybody have to follow the all the rules and regulations of the scriptures. And so, here Ramananda, he quoted one verse, Nana Upachara Kritona Pujana Arthabandhu Premanaiva Bhakta Hidayam Sukha Vidrutan Sat Javad Kudanti Jatari Pipasa Tabot Sukhaya Bhavatu Nanubhaksha Peya. Then, if you are not hungry, if you get many kinds of foodstuffs, then you will not eat. But if you are very hungry, then you can eat all kinds of foodstuffs. In the same way, Bhagavan is called Artho Bandhu. He is the friend of the devotee who is hankering offered to him.
इसे कहते हैं नानो उपचार कृतनो पूजनो आर्त बंधु प्रेम नैव भक्त हृदय सुख विद्रुत सत् जावत खुदती खुदंती जठरे जठरा पिपासा तावत सुखाय भवतु ननुभक्ष पेय सो अनदर वर्स राइटर मन ही कोटेड दिस इज राजानुगा भक्ति नाउ
कृष्ण भक्ति रसभाविता मती क्रियतां यदि कुतोपि लभते तत्र लुलमोपि मूल्यमेकं जन्मकडे सुकृतेन लभते यू कैन नॉट अटेन टू द हाईएस्ट प्रेम ब्रज प्रेम जस्ट योर ओन सुकृति बट हाउ विल अटेन द हाईएस्ट ब्रज प्रेम If you see one's heart completely full of brajarosh, just you pay your greed, listen Hari Katha from his lotus lips, that is called Lobhamayi Bhakti. And two kinds of Bhakti already I told, one is called Vaidhi Bhakti. Vaidhi, there are many names of Vaidhi Bhakti. Vaidhi Bhakti, one name is called Aisarya Mula Bhakti. The opulence mode, Vaidhi Bhakti is. Vaidhi Bhakti is another name is called Shastra Anushasanmayi Bhakti. And following the rules and regulation of the scriptures, for this regard, this is called Shastra Anushasanmayi Bhakti. Vaidhi Bhakti is another name also called Bhaitpadika Bhakti. Bhai Utpadika Bhakti. Bhaitpadika Bhakti. Because our Shastra explains, if you not follow the rules and regulation of the scriptures, then you will go to the hell. For this regard, you practice this bhakti. So for this regard, bhakti's name is called Bhaya Utpadika Bhakti. Understand? Bhaya Utpadika. Just to give an example, if you not follow the, if you not and observe Ekadasi, then you will go hell because in the day of Ekadasi, all kinds of germs of sinful activities remain in the grains. So for this regard, you observe Ekadasi. So these types of observing Ekadasi and bhakti, but this bhakti is called Bhayutpadika bhakti. Bhayutpadika. And another bhakti is called spontaneous Raganuga bhakti. Spontaneous in your previous sanskar impressions and or the association of sadhus spontaneously and observe Ekadasi and for the exclusive pleasure for Krishna. So this type of bhakti is called Raganuga bhakti. So two kinds of bhakti also. So here also explain Krishna bhakti rasabhavita mati kriyatang jadi kutopi labhate tatra lulam lulamapi mullamekam janma kate sukhana labhate. So that means you have to pay your greed. Listen Harikatha from the pure devotees of Krishna. This is something. प्रभु कहे हाय आगे कह आर राय कहे दस प्रेम सर्वशब्द सार देन चैतन्य महाप्रभु वेरी प्लीज देन चैतन्य महाप्रभु टोल्ड आई एम प्लीज बार आई वांट टू लिसन मोर एंड यू गो एंड एड ऑन देन राय मंद ही टोल्ड राय कहे दस प्रेम सर्वशब्द सार जन्मा जन्नाम सुति मात्रे न पुमान भवते निर्मल तस्व तीर्थ पदं किं दास नाम अवशिष्यति. वेरी नाइस ब्यूटिफुल दिस श्लोक इज आल्सो एंड दैट मींस राय रमानंद ही स्टार्ट द दास प्रेम कथा इज हियर एंड एक्चुअल हनुमान ही इज द परफेक्ट दास प्रेमिक एंड ही इज वन पॉइंटेड विथ हिज मास्टर लॉर्ड राम चंद्र दस प्रेम राम सो हनुमान इज कॉल्ड द परफेक्ट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दस प्रेम शुद्ध दस देन चैतन्य महाप्रभु टोल प्रभु कहे ये आगे कहो आर ओके आई एग्री बट आई लिसन मोर
देन राय कही सक प्रेम सर्वसाध्य सार देन राय रमानंद ही ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन अबाउट सख प्रेम शुद्ध सख एंड प्योर फ्रेंडशिप मोड विथ कृष्ण दैट इज ओनली ब्रज इन द हार्ट ऑफ सुबल श्रीदाम एंड ही ऑल्सो गेव एविडेंस फ्रॉम श्रीमद भागवतम 10th कैंटो 12th चैप्टर श्लोक नंबर 11 इत्तं सतं ब्रह्म सुखानुभूत दसंगतानं परदैवतेन मायाश्रितानं नरदारकेन सद्दं विजहो कृतपूर्णपुञ्जा सद्दं विजहो कृतपूर्णपुञ्जा श्रीमद्भागवतम सुखदेव गोस्वामी पाद टोल्ड परीक्षित महाराज इत्थं सदां ब्रह्म सुखानुभूतम इन इम्पार्शलिस्ट ब्रह्म ज्ञानी हाउ दे आर लेस इंटेलिजेंट दे वांट टू मर्ज इन ब्रह्म सुखा द हैप्पीनेस ऑफ ब्रह्म द हैप्पीनेस ऑफ ब्रह्म एज लाइक द व्हाट इज कॉल्ड वार्म ब्लू जुगनू के भांति है और हर इज द कृष्ण प्रेम है सो थिंक दसंग गतनांग परदैव तेनम दूज द डिवोटी ऑफ दस दे आर थिंकिंग लॉर्ड ही इज द सुप्रीम पर्सनलिटी ऑफ गॉड इज एंड भगवान है ऐश्वर्य युक्त दास माया श्रितानांग नरदार केनो दूज हु आर कंप्लीटली इलुसिडेड बाय माया दे आर थिंक कृष्ण ही इज एन ऑर्डिनरी काउहर्ड बॉय साधं बीज कृतपुण पुंजा बट द फ्रेंड्स ऑफ कृष्ण सुबल श्रीदाम हाउ दे परफॉर्म स्वीट लीला विथ कृष्ण सख भाव है सो टुमारो विल बी डिस्कस वत्सल भाव नाउ फ्रेंड्स जो गुरु प्रेमानंदी हरि बोलो राय रमानंद की जय 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 श्री राधे है चैतन्य महाप्रभु राय रमानंद ही टोल्ड प्रभु यू हैव टू स्टे हियर एट लीस्ट 10 डेज बट चैतन्य महाप्रभु से जावत जीवत तावत रही तुम्हारे संगे एंड अंटिल गिव अप माई बॉडी आई ऑलवेज स्टे विथ यू एंड लिसन हरि कथा फ्रॉम योर लोटस लिप्स रसिकेन और रसिकेन जो ज्योति बिकॉज इन दिस वे लॉर्ड चैतन्य महाप्रभु राय रमानंद डिस्कस सो मेनी स्वीट कथा एंड देन ऑल्सो लेटर वी विल डिस्कस यहाँ एंड चैतन्य महाप्रभु and manifested his highest form, that is called Rasaraj Mahabhav. And when Raya Ramananda, he saw Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Rasaraj Mahabhav Sarup, dekhi, Raya Ramananda hoila murchit. Then Raya Ramananda, he completely fainted, these things. So maybe also next day we'll discuss why Raya Ramananda, he fainted when he saw Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Rasaraj महाभाव स्वरूप गुरु प्रेमानंदी हरि हरि गुरुदेव की जय 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 श्री राध 5 o'clock जय माधवी प्रिया अनंग मोहिनी देवी रामानंद रामानंद प्रभु जय 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 हरि बोल।